Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of TimeSplitters 2 Arcade Edition. Today we are going to be doing, I have no idea. This is part of my marathon upload, TimeSplitters Edition. I've decided that instead of doing so many things at once, I'm just going to do TimeSplitters one day, Super Mario the next day. And then I'm going to be doing all of 2 2/2 at some point, which should be fun, right? Not right. Alright, this is Team Series B. This is more annoying. Last one was annoying. This one's fun. I like this one. This is the one I got confused with the last one. Hacker with the time to split, because it's the same area. I think you're playing as the same character, so that's what threw me off. My apologies, but whatever. I'm sorry, you're not playing as the same character. I guess you're fighting the same characters, or you're fighting the cyber hackers, so that's why I got confused. Anyway, this is the last challenge mode that I'm going to be doing for the TimeSplitters Let's Play. Not the last challenge mode that I will be doing forever, but, as of right now, in the foreseeable future, not planning on doing much. I mean, I will eventually, but I gotta take a break from this game once I beat the story mode. The challenges are fun, but it's just too much. So I'm probably going to be doing Super Mario for a while and the next Let's Play that I'm planning on doing. And I might bring this back every couple parts or so. You know, take a break from wrestling. Whereas I like doing the wrestling videos, I need to get the rest of this up. Ow! Heck, who's got the rocket launcher? I want it. By the way, you can kill your partners with the ricochets, which is always a lot. Hey! Don't shoot at me and then run away. Dang, did we just blow his head off? I think we did. That might have been his hat, but it looked like his head. Come on. I want to get in on the last kill. Over there. They're somewhere. Sense them. And I get the silver award. Woo! Much coolness. Much coolness. So, next up, we're going to be doing possibly the most annoying mission in this entire patch. Why is it annoying? Because the AI is as dumb as a rock. Seriously. I cannot imagine what they were doing when they were programming this AI. Back up. That one. Yeah, this one. Just annoying. Just flat out annoying. You're playing as Ghost, which is awesome because I love Ghost. Ghost is just all kinds of retarded coolness. Because, I mean, let's face it. That intro that he had just looked awesome. But this is a grab the bag mission. For those of you that are not aware of what grab the bag is, think capture the flag. That's literally all you gotta do. I don't know what happened right there, but whatever. With my voice, not the video. Video's running great. So what you just saw right there was a large jump cut of about 20 minutes of footage, because this video was originally over 32 minutes long. Well, I guess that was 10 minutes of footage. But, This mission. What you want to do is what I'm doing right now. You want to always have the cloak power up, always want to have some armor on you, and you always want to have the minigun, or one of the plasma machine guns. Now you might be wondering, why would we want that, Shade? Shut up! It's only the best way to do this, because the other guys have some kind of seeking radar for you. By the way, only shoot at them when they have the bag, otherwise let the AI do their job. You cannot score if somebody else has your bag. So what you want to do is you always want to make sure that if you see that message, to grab their bag and then find them your bag and kill them. Because again, you need to let the AI do its job. Also, you want to be really careful, because if you're... Hey, get back here! My bag! Running! I got your bag! This is probably the most annoying mission I've ever done. This is not fun. This is tedium to maximum level. You all may be wondering, well, how is it tedium to the maximum level? Well, for one, that. They will constantly be getting at you because your guys have, like, no health, no armor, nothing whatsoever. You have this outrageously long time limit. If they die, they will spawn right on top of you and start shooting you. Why that one didn't die, I will never know. Because I'm not quite questioning you with a gift from God. But if you have the cloaking power up, as you see, sometimes they won't shoot at you. Sometimes you'll go under their radar, as long as you don't shoot at them. The minigun is the most powerful gun on this map, probably the most powerful gun ever to have existed on this map. So, that's what I would suggest having at any given moment on this map. And again, armor pickups are your friends. Make sure this thing always has plenty of ammunition. Make sure you always get the bag. Make sure they always die if they have your bag. Why don't you get an armor pickup? I didn't even get to keep it all the way to the end. But yeah. I'm making it look really simple right now, but this took like 4 or 5 takes. And again, make sure if you see that they have the bag, pick up theirs and kill their dude with your bag. Because if you do not kill their dude with your bag, you can't score. And I swear to God, the AI in this game is, well, in this particular level, is stupid as a rock, and sometimes they're just completely brilliant, because I had one run where they had our bag, and we had their bag, and nobody would give way. My guys couldn't get to their guy with the bag, and they couldn't get to me with the bag, so nobody could score, and I had 4! You need 5 to beat that! But anyway, now we're going to an assault mission. What? Ah, that's right. I remember. This is a little insight into Mr. Tipper's lifestyle. Well, not lifestyle, but what he has to usually go through. This is an assault mission, and this is probably the most painful assault mission I've ever had to do. Essentially, there are 3 parts to this assault mission. You have to take out the forward guns, you have to get... Or, 4 parts, I'm sorry. You have to take out the forward guns. You have to get access to the hangar. You have to get into the hangar. And then you have to blow up the gas barrels in order to keep the other team from escaping. Now, here's the thing. The guns are everywhere. I'm not just talking, you know, video game everywhere. Where it's just kind of like, oh no, it's like in five places and I can't find any good cover. No, seriously. There are two guns out on either side of this entrance right here. There are two guns on this side of this door. There's a gun when you walk through the door. There's a gun when you... That's the only way to describe this. You want to know the easy way of taking these things out? I'll show you in a little bit. Right now, I'm just being an idiot, and I figured I would leave this in for your guys' attention. Because I know how much viewers love to watch the main character mess up repeatedly over and over and over and over and over. This is a smart way of doing it, but there's a smarter way of doing it. Why we're playing as Harry Tipper's giant-handed girlfriend, I will never know. Again, don't stand too close to the things after they explode, because they will kill you. They will injure you. They will do nasty things to your life. I don't know why I said that one. Again, I don't know what half the stuff is that comes out of my mouth. I'll admit, the toughest one to get is that one on the box right there. However, if you can get behind it before everything kills you, it's your best bet. Now, you can do some of these objectives out of order, like this one right here. You can... Oh, never mind. I'm just kidding. You have to take out the guns before you can be granted access into the hangar. And before you can get access to the hangar, you have to be granted access to blah, 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 blah. Okay, now, you may not have caught it, so I'm gonna do it again in a second. But that's the smart way of doing it. Unless you have the shotgun, then you're pretty much blown. But if you can get behind the guns, or you can find a Soviet rifle with grenades, that's the way to go. By the way, don't shoot Tipper, he'll get really mad at you. Can you tell it's been a while since I've played this level? I mean, it's only completely obvious. The only people in this level that you're fighting are Kalos' goons and Kalos' grunt. You've got the basic grunt, you've got the elite grunt. I'm trying to decide who shot me. Because whoever it is got me. That's another thing. If you can disable the little red chip that you see to shoot it enough times, the guns won't be able to fire at you because they won't have their guidance system or whatever. I can't believe that I've been talking about this level for 3 minutes and I've got to re-talk over it because I die at the end. Spoilers! Sometimes I don't get paid. I don't get paid anything. Just a hobby. I'm not a YouTube partner yet. I don't have any aspirations for being a YouTube partner. And Tipper running in the background. Well, apparently he got out of here. Rocket launcher. How come I can't have a rocket launcher? I want a rocket launcher. Okay, that's one gun down. Ow. 2 guns down. Ow. Ow, 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 ow. Finally, that's everybody. And I managed to kill my teammates. Yeah! Wait, I can do this. No, I'm not going to. Go grab the armor. Do it! Grab the armor. Yeah, there you go. I don't know why the random scientist. Yeah. Well, I'm officially cloned. Final Fantasy Remix. You've just been cloned FTW. You are dead, you're dead because we killed you. Well, I will be dead in about 30 seconds because I have no way of making it to that thing. Dude! My gun! Anyway, so you come up here, you get your access, 10 seconds, access granted, and then the vault door opens. Well, and then you just, yeah, you gotta go in here, right, to the lab, and there's the hang. Now, you get to watch me do this all over again, and do it the smart way. Now, what you want to do is you want to run their Soviet rifles under both of them. And since you can pretty much pick up a new gun at every point, my suggestion is just spam the grenades. Spam it like there is no tomorrow. You may be called cheap, you may be called insecure, guess what? It works! The guns get taken out super quickly. I'm already further than I was in the first 2 minutes of the last video. Because if you just spam the grenades, it kills everything around you. The guns, the henchmen, Kalos, everything. The only one that you can't do it to is that one on the box. What you have to do for that one, or the smarter thing to do, is get behind it and upload it. Unless you get an extremely lucky shot with a grenade like I did right there. By the way, strafe left and right. I cannot stress that enough. You know, you think once you hit the guidance chip out, you would be able to just... I don't know. It would randomly shoot at everyone. Alright, so I've got two more guns, and I've got 6 minutes to do it. Roughly 2 minutes, but... through the grenade! My job to spam the grenades, your guys' job to make sure I can spam the grenades by taking care of all the enemies and using yourself as a human body. Shield. Human body shield. That's what I mean. I've been doing this for so long today. I mean, I'm taking small breaks, but, this is why I break everything. So, next up is the next dome in Super Mario Galaxy. I got that all recorded. That's going up on YouTube just soon after these. So, enjoy, be merry, and please, God help me. And one more. Yeah! Alright. Get Hangar 2 open. Hangar 2 is open. Yeah, see, that's extremely easier than the last one. The next one, destroying the fuel barrels. Not hard if you know what a fuel barrel is. However, I still would suggest spamming the crap out of the assault rifle's grenade function if you can get your hand on them. It's easier to get your hand on other guns, and you can just easily blow up the fuel barrels with your pistol, as you see. You know, I would have gotten the gold if I would have, you know, hung in to get that last one. But no, I had to be shot for no reason. I'm sorry, I would have been able to get the silver award. My bad. So, spoilers, I can't do any more of these, not because of the previous reason said, but because I have to go back and beat one of these levels. Anyone want to take a guess at what that is? That's right, it's the last one of the last level. Mr. Handy! I hate Mr. Handy. I hate that level in general. But, I am ShadeGrey. I have been your humble announcer for these some odd number of videos. And I will see you next time on TimeSplitters 2 something or other. So, cheerio, good day, and I will be seeing you next time. I don't wanna go back to that level. Oh, this is just gonna drive me crazy. Because you literally have to beat all the levels in order for anything to unlock in the Elite League. Maybe you have to have all gold. I sure as hell hope you don't have to have all gold. If it is, then you're gonna have to look up somebody else's video because I'm not doing it. Not doing it. I can't do it. It's physically impossible. So, anyway, later guys, I'll be seeing you sometime in the near future. Later!